The world of crime. It's international. Everywhere in the world covers the crime genre. Everywhere from Italy with giallo, Hong Kong with hard-boiled, and even classic modern Hollywood with its noir, neo-noir, and gangster mix of crime films. All of which come from types of crime fiction. Even the inclusion of the Western films, the classic days of the old gunslinger, martial art films, samurai films, all of these can be included in the crime genre. Classic tropes these movies have are corrupt people, thieves, bad guys, murderers, all tropes that can be included in the crime genre. This is the world of crime. But what about the history of the crime genre? To go back to crime, you really have to see the real history of it. From the days of outlaw cowboys, where people robbed banks, held up trains, to now where it's still occurring in the modern era. It's all been represented back into film. The earliest example is of 1903's The Great Train Robbery from Edison. It's a short film where bandits hold up a train. That's basically the gist of the film. This short film about train robbers is so historically significant to film, its negatives still exist at the Library of Congress. With innovative camera trickery and sets, it helped pave the way of cinema to what we know today. But by popular use, it dates back to the classic crime novels. Some as far back as Sherlock Holmes, earlier Edgar Allan Poe stories, Dickens, and even the Arabian Nights. Crime has existed through the ages. Other depictions of crime were done through magazines called pulp magazines or pulp fiction. These were popularized from the 1890s to the 1950s. But now in Hollywood, which is what the majority of the focus this piece is going to be on, once the boom of cinema began, this genre was tackled among the many. It wasn't until the 1930s when it really kicked off with the gangster subgenre of crime. Thanks to the popularity of people such as Al Capone and Don Dillinger, people wanted to watch movies surrounding people of that status. These people, for who they were and what they were capable of, were not only notorious, but also idolized. Movies were released, for example, The Public Enemy from 1931 featuring James Cagney, Little Caesar 1931 featuring Edward G. Robinson, and the heavily controversial yet popular Scarface from 1932 featuring Paul Muni and directed by Howard Hawks, which was as close of a depiction of Al Capone you could get at that time. The 1930s depicted the era it was in, so vivid it was scary to people because this was happening. It was the Great Depression and the crime wave was skyrocketing with murders, smugglers, counterfeiting, drug alcohol trafficking, etc. It was being depicted during the pre-code era of crime in cinema. Crime films elsewhere show not only the crime portion of the genre, but the darkness of it as well. When M was released Among the Many in 1931 and was directed by Fritz Lang, this was showcasing the international quality and ever-growing state of the crime syndicate. By the 1940s era of Hollywood was when it all was taking a turn. This era began hot as the novel popularity of crime fiction was now being put to screen. Enters actor Humphrey Bogart. He set the standard among many actors for a new approach in the crime genre, with the focus on characters like detectives getting involved with heavy cases. We follow the characters through the film, solving the case as well as having a traditional love interest come into their lives. Characters can be built as being cynical, especially the hero, as well as fatalism and moral ambiguity. The movies are mostly built on suspense, and we feel that suspense due to the large use of lighting and shadows in the scene. The shots are lit with a term called low-key lighting. This is what emphasizes the shadows and harsh lighting. This creates more depth and volume to a picture. The films that stood out in the film noir subgenre were films like The Big Combo, The Maltese Falcon, Touch of Evil, Double Indemnity, and many more. This movement is still in continuation and managed to spiral into its own subgenre when neo-noir was born. Neo-noir takes a lot of the same traits as regular noir, but mostly blend between modern, postmodern, and or futuristic environments. Other phrases included hard-boiled and neo-classic. The most applicable films that worked with neo-noir are films like Sin City, Blade Runner, Drive, Usual Suspects, LA Confidential, The Town. In the film and pop culture world, the Batman franchise also stands out as being neo-noir. But true crime films are worked from those true stories about crime bosses and gangsters. Such as the work from the 1930s, there was still a big margin of films being made based around real-life gangsters. The Godfather, for example, the remake of Scarface, and more. But the man who utilized this adaption was filmmaker Martin Scorsese. He worked with what he knew. Growing up in New York, he saw all kinds of characters roaming around. When it came time to work on his first film, he was suggested to work on what he knew. And he did that with Mean Streets from 1973. Then he moved on to incorporating other crime genre tropes with the neo-noir themed Taxi Driver from 1976. But by the 90s, he worked on some of his best work, incorporating true stories to film with Goodfellas and Casino. We saw these people that were larger than life taking full control of their environments and reaching to the top with money and power. Workers in both films were Robert De Niro and Joe Pesci. They established how we saw gangsters on the big screen. They invoked charisma, drama, and they worked to convince you that they were the real deal. But for these films, what are the constituents of the genre for the gangster films? The movies all start off with the already established or yet to be established main protagonist slash anti-hero. They show their lives and backstories that pull you into the film. The Godfather began with showing the family and establishing the power Marlon Brando as Don Corleone has as the Godfather. Scarface shows Al Pacino as Tony Montana coming in on a boat, escaping from the refugee camp and moving on to sell drugs. Goodfellas shows a young Henry Hill getting his foot into the mafia's door at a young age and showing what it's like through the young eyes as a wannabe gangster. Casino shows the power and monopoly Sam and his Las Vegas cronies have and what you need to do to survive on top in Las Vegas. These are powerful beginnings in films that show you how powerful these characters and their tropes really are. These movies, however, have such different ranges in form of editing and pacing. The Godfather is a slow drama about a crime family that's heavily dialogue-based, while Goodfellas works with a lot of jumps in time to precise moments of relevance. They all work their own way, and there is something for everyone in these films that way. They all have strong build on character and environments around them. They talk over food, they deal with family issues, and if they need to, they'll whack someone who gets on their bad side.
No, no.
All while trying to establish themselves as made men in an intense environment all within the crime syndicate. Crime films are as relevant as the day they started making them. Not only is it reflecting on the drama, power, rise and fall people go through when it's this lifestyle, it also stays relevant as long as crime is a relevant topic, which will always be the case. My way of working with crime in film would be to look back at these classic films and note what works. For me as a director and writer, and for the audience watching, there's a huge market for crime as people sadistically fall in awe over these larger-than-life characters. Characters are so important and so is dialogue. These are my favourite tropes for a film as they keep my interest and I know it keeps a lot of people's interest. Also, I'm a big fan of the classic noir as well as the more modern neo-noir. Scorsese, Coppola, De Palma, for example, I'm big fans of. So, if I were to write my own crime film, it would be very easy to find inspiration, especially from artists like that. That was The World of Crime.